Good morning, everyone. Like in the
Good
last class, we are trying to identify some of the concepts here. Like we are creating the registration page here. So we'll check how exactly we can create this particular registration page here. So what are the steps we need to follow to create the particular registration page? So observe here what I created. Yesterday we worked on the some taglib directory here, and now so whenever I specified here, we can specify some ID here. So form ID, something called registration form, and we need to specify model attribute. We need to specify model attribute is nothing but our registration object here, and after that action. So where exactly it has to go after click on the submit. So register process. Okay, and now the last one method post we need to specify. So these are the main property we need to specify here. After that, what we can do here? So what I'm doing here, I want to create some table style here. Inside the table, what we are going to do here? TR TD username. So when TD is completed, now one more TD I open here. Okay, so internally we are going to have form input path is equals to username, right? Now so we'll check with this, and after that what we can do, we'll close our TD. Same way we'll try to focus on the one more tier, and observe here I'm trying to copy. Let me make format here first. Okay, so this is the same format I'm trying to use. So we define some of the properties in the particular class. Go back to the class which we defined yesterday. Something called register.java. So we specified the username. And now, so here we need to specify the property of the variable, and let me make to the password. First name. And last name. Email. Address, the last one, phone number. Phone number, right. Now we specified the properties here. After specifying the properties, what we can do here? we need to create a one more tr here, and internally I am creating one td here. So just I want to give some style of this particular field, and now make here one button here. Button type, submit, register. So this is the way we can work on the register. Okay, now save this particular application, because we created one registration page here, and go back to the our application. We'll try to run the same example here. Okay, so instead of going to run, we need to change some configuration also, right? And where we need to change, and where we define the class here, controller class, so instead of returning home directly, what we can do here, register we can return. Okay, we are having register page. Let me save the class here. Now I'm trying to run in the server. Okay, so you can check here, the home page is triggered here, the home page is called here, but after calling we are having some issue here. So we can check here, binding result or plain text to the bname register available as a request attribute. The request attributes we are not passing the request attribute here, is nothing but this particular field is not identified here whenever we are trying to load register page. So what we can do here, simply what we have to do here, we need to return the particular object called register here. We need to return register object here. How we can return this particular register object here? So observe here, go back to our controller class, home controller. In the home controller, we are trying to return the particular register page here. So let me make here model attribute annotation. One second, Eclipse is not responding. Register. Okay, now Let me try one more time here. So observe here, what we are doing here, we are able to see the some particular registration page here, getting the point. So now we will check with some property, username card. Spring MVC, the password I am giving, okay. So path we specified, I guess we need to change to the password style because it is expecting text only. That we can change later. Okay, first name spring, last name MVC. So email here spring@mvc.com and address something called, again I'm giving spring. So phone number, some random number I want to give. Okay, so after click on the registration, where it is going here, you can check here, it's coming as a register process. It's coming as a register process. So this particular register process, as of now, we did not implement it. Now what we can do, we'll copy this particular register process. Now we'll create a one more method, public. So we'll return string here, or we can return model and view object here, and register process. Getting the point. So now this is our path, and specify here. And now what I need to specify here, because we are expecting post method. Okay, so we specify the particular post here and copy this. Now what we can do, so simply first we'll create one model object, model and view, something called view. Model and view. So here what I can return here, simply the home page I will try to return. The home page I will return with some information. Right. What information we are trying to return here? View dot add object with specifying message, some key value pair we need to return, that is called some register I want to return. Some message, registration process is success. Right. Return view. Okay. But whenever we are getting this particular register object, whether we are getting all the information or not, how we can check here? By printing register dot some get username we will print. Okay. Now in the home page, what I can specify here? we need to specify this particular attribute information. Getting the point. So to work on that, what we can do, we'll try to check with some information. Let me open the home page and we'll try to inside the what I can specify this particular register. There is a home page. We'll get some information here that we'll see. I'm trying to run one more time. So we are getting the registration page here. Username Spring and password Spring. So first name also Spring, second name MVC, springmvc.com, so something called SimpMVC address, some random number. Okay, let me clear. We'll check here where exactly it's going. Now you can check here. So Spring MVC is printed along with this, but we are expecting what here? The message we are expecting here. What we are expecting here? The message. Okay. Now observe, to return this particular message, what we can do, instead of returning this, we'll make some dollar here. Let me refresh this. You can see what we are getting here. The registration process success. Where we define this message? We define this message in the particular home controller. So this message we are getting or not? So this is the way we can return whatever we want to return the output to the particular appropriate view page. So using this particular Spring MVC, what we are going to do? We'll try to communicate with the database to work on the objects here. Getting the point. So this is the way we can work on the anything. But now what I want to specify, this request mapping along with the post, we are having some other information. So first we'll check with the get here. So what is the difference we are going to get? So to make some security, we'll work on the post here. So basically, you are unable to see any information here except this particular URL and where exactly the request is going. And after the information, after the particular REST API, so it's calling the register process, but we are not finding anything. So simply, model is nothing but what object we want to return, and view is nothing but it's a view page, what page we want to return. So that's the reason I'm telling here, this is a view page we are processing here, and this is the object is nothing but the model object, what object we want to show on the particular view page, that is we are trying to specifying here. So it's a simple one. We don't have much information in the particular this. So this is the key value pair is going to expect here. That is a good option to work on the key value pair, because the key we can specify in the any particular view pages, the value is going to render on the particular view page. So that we have seen the registration process is success. But here you can define like in the some different format using the HTML CSS styles. So that is the way we can elaborate more. Okay, that is the different here. Now we have identified these are the properties are available and okay, we identified. Now what we want to do here, we'll check with the validation part here. We check with the validation part. So how we can validate if we miss something on the each property? Getting the point. If I'm going to run one more time, we are able to see the particular page here. So we'll see the particular page called registration page. But if I miss any property, I want to validate. Okay, so observe here, I miss the username, or if I'm directly clicking the register process, I'm going to the home page here, but I don't want to go to the home page. I want to stay in the particular the registration page. Getting the point. So why I want to wait in the registration page? Because so we did not fill the appropriate fields here. So we want to get some validation message. To work on that, what we can do? So simply what we can do, first we'll go back to the particular registration page. Here we are having, we'll check with the one more TD, that is nothing but errors. Let me save. Why we are getting this error? The tag handler class of form errors. Web select tags form error tag was not found. Okay. If the error tag was not found, we'll check any other. No. Okay, so it is resolved here. What I am doing here, I'm trying to specifying some, if we miss anything, any field we want to show. Validation. Password, okay, username is specified. So let me save here, and after saving, what we have to write here? We'll go back to the particular register class here. Here, what kind of the annotation we can specify? So getting the point. Now, here I'm trying to specify one pattern here. On the username, okay, so we are not getting the pattern here because we did not added only one jar we added, right? Okay, WebMVC and Servlet API. So we need to add Hibernate related jars here. So let me check with the Hibernate related jars what exactly we want to add here. Maven repository. In the Maven repository, first we'll check with the Hibernate core, and once the Hibernate core is fine, what we can do? We'll check with the Hibernate validator. This is the Hibernate validator we are adding. Okay, after Hibernate validator, so we'll check any errors if we get based on the some dependencies. Those dependencies are also we are going to add here. Okay, after adding here, we'll check here the pattern attribute here. What happened? Still we are not getting. Okay, we are getting the size, but why the particular pattern we are not getting here? Okay, so we are getting the pattern also. Maybe initially it is not loaded, I guess. Observe here, whenever we are having these two annotation, what we are going to write here? Based on the particular size annotation, what is going to do? If you want to specify minimum characters or maximum characters, you can go for the particular size here. So something called this particular size, we can work on the this password annotation. Here we are having minimum how many characters we need? 6. Getting the point. And maximum, how many we need around, so we can specify 10. So between these we need, right? And one message, if we are not matching the minimum and maximum, it's not matched, what we can do? The password must be 6 characters, some message, the password must be 6 characters. Same way in the user, so in the username, what we can specify? So now we need to specify the regular expression here, and the regular expression is going to take alphanumeric values here. How exactly it's going to take here? Here I want to specify inside this A to Z and A to Z. So this is only we need to specify. And if there's something we are trying to write, we need to specify the message. Username must be a what is the message we can specify? Characters. Must be a username cannot include numbers. This is better. Some message. Okay. Now other properties. What we can do? Same. Password we specified. Username, sorry, first name also we are going to work on the same. And email. So to make email, we are having the different here. But now, so simply we'll work on this particular, the same validation here. And email something called last name, first name, and we can work on the for address also same annotation, and for mobile number what we can do. So we'll specify 029. We'll specify 029. Cannot include characters. So this message I want to implement here. This message I want to implement. So observe how exactly it's going to work. Getting the point. Now where we can go, so we'll check with, do we need to define anything in the particular controller class. So we'll go back to the controller class and we'll find here what we are writing here, only the first one call model attribute. So why we are using this particular model attribute? To get an the particular object here, we need to use this particular model attribute here. So where we are getting this object here, we specified in the register.jsp as a model attribute. So that's we are trying to get. And here by loading also we need to specify. Why we are specifying? The server is nothing but container cannot understanding this particular object here. Because of here we specified model attribute as a register. Getting the point. So that's the reason we need to specify the what kind of object we are trying to return. Basically we are working on the where the spring related tag library. So it's going to directly communicate with the property of this particular class. So to understand which class we are trying to communicate, we are specifying with the camel case system here. That is nothing but the capital letter, the first capital letter is going to be small, remaining letter should be same. Right, now come to the home controller. In the home controller what we can specify here, so simply we need to specify the binding result. Some result. Okay, so this is only we need to specify. We'll see whether this particular object we are getting or not with any errors. So how we can identify? So simply I want to make some condition here, result dot has errors. If this particular result having any errors, what I can do? Simply, I will return model and view with the same page called register. Right. So else we can work on this part. Else we can work on this part. Let me save. And so go back to the, okay, maybe so this is, I guess Multiple annotation form from Spring Framework tags was not found in the Java build path. Why it is not founding? Earlier it was found. Okay, we'll see whether it's going to working or not. We are getting some errors in the particular JSP file. So anyway, we'll try to check. What happened here? So we are getting local validator factory bin invocation, no class def. Okay, static logger binary is expecting here. So this we need to figure it out. It's nothing but it is a one dependency. Okay, so we did not copy this. It is a one kind of dependency we need to add. So that is we already added into the when we are communicating with the Hibernate. Now go back to the pom.xml. Okay, along with this, so we'll try to add one more. Okay, not in Hibernate, I guess. Okay, so maybe the Spring 7. I will add this one also, because again we'll get, because definitely this is also, it's going to dependent. Okay, let me save all the files here. Now again I want to run the same example here. Okay, let me stop. Reloading is completed, but we stopped the server. Okay, still we are getting, okay, Jaxpy we are getting here. This is also one kind of, this is also one kind of dependency. I guess this also we added. Now I'm trying to add this particular dependency also. Okay, so to understanding more, so this is the way we need to figure it out, like what is an exception we are getting, what is the resolution of the each exception here. Okay, now we did not see any errors. We have received the home page here. Getting the point. Simply I will click on the next. So it is not calling here. Okay, maybe that because of this particular JSP. What happened this? So now basically these tags are not working, I guess. We'll check with you. We'll take help from the Google. Why? Anything we are missing? Prefix URI. Okay. JSTL, okay, recording. Okay, one more library we miss, I guess. We'll check. Let me save. No. Okay, JSTL, it's not there. Again, we need to add the JSTL libraries here. Go back to the pom.xml. Anywhere we added here? No. So, so JSTL libraries we need to specify here. Let me stop the server. Okay, first we'll check the registration page. Now the issue was resolved, but still we are getting this. Okay, was not found on the Java build. Okay, we'll figure it out. Maybe those are not related to this. So whenever we are working on this particular Spring related form tags, we need to specify the appropriate libraries. But even though still we are getting some errors here, no, actually this is not the errors. Okay, we'll see. This is, we need to debug why the tag bundler class ORG's framework was not found on the Java build. But if it is not found, the tag it has to generate it, but it is generating is nothing but maybe will take one time build. So okay, build also success. Still we are having, we'll see this time. Oh, what happened? This time we are getting an exception. So what is the error we are getting? Illegal argument exception. Something, oh my god. Again I am getting this. Yes, I am working on the some 4 version related jars here. So what are the jars recently we added? go back to the pom.xml. Okay. Let me check any Hibernate validator, three version related jars, because the fourth version is expecting 1.8. Four version is expecting 1.8 Java 8. So that's the reason I changed to the okay. So this is not the full one. We'll check this one. And instead of binding result, so we have an annotation here that is called validated. Let me run one more time here. So when we are working with MVC related application, it's going to take some time because every time we need to start the server, and if we get any exception, again we need to stop and we need to figure it out what kind of exception we are getting. Again, we are getting you can check here, pattern cannot be resolved your type. So okay, the three version is not working here. java.lang.error constructor throw an exception. Go back to the class. Any errors we are getting? Yes. Here we are getting an errors here. Let me remove this particular patterns here. Save the classes. Maybe in the third version these annotations are not available. Hey, it's available. The size. Now you can identify. Yeah, the naming package with this particular annotation package is changed here, and we can check this particular regular expression information also. Okay, anything we miss? Let me save. Okay, so now we are getting the home page, but we need to check whether this home page will work or not. No. Okay, it is not working. what exactly we are missing. Okay. Because of this, I will comment this. Let me change. Oh. Okay. We'll go back to the main method. No. Okay. Okay, so that is, I will figure it out, because whatever the configuration we made, so this is the correct configuration. We have specified the validator, and whenever anything we are getting, so we are going to find in the result object here, and the result object is going to return if it is having any errors. It is having any errors. What is going to do? Simply it's return the same page here, but that's we are expecting here. But still, the validator class is not loading here. So I guess I'm not missing anything. Let me one more time check the code. Validator, module attribute, binding result, result. So from the prospective controller class is correct. The control regression patterns. Okay, this is also correct. Okay, no problem. I'll figure it out, and on Monday I'm going to explain. So where we missed some configuration information or something, I will explain you. And once it is completed, so I'm requesting everyone. So as of now, we have identified, we are able to get the register object here, right? So using this particular register object, and go to the communicate with the Hibernate what exactly we have covered in the last class, and what are the configuration we implemented, and use the same implementation into this particular Spring MVC. So try to communicate with the database. So try to save the record into the database and update the records. So try to focus on this some code operation. So I will continue this validation example on Monday. But meanwhile, so work on the CUD operation using the JDBC and Hibernate, what exactly we discussed in the last classes. Okay, if you are having any questions, go to our recorded session, and each and every video is uploaded in the particular path. Okay, once this example is completed, now I will move on to the Spring Boot related examples, and we'll work on some Postman related, using we'll work on the REST APIs, how we can implement the REST APIs, and how exactly the REST APIs are going to communicate it. So those will continue on Monday. Any questions regarding this, except this particular validation? Yes, tell me.
So here you are using model and view, right, in the line number 26.
Yes.
So we have one more attribute like model also, right? So what is the difference between this and that?
So the name only it's showing, right? Model is nothing but only the data, whatever we want to return.
So that means whatever the data we want to show in the UI, that data, you want to use that data, we will use the model.
Yes.
So model and view, we just render this page and we just show to the UI.
Yes, render the model and in the constructor what we are specifying, it is nothing but it's a logical view name.
Okay. That means so home page it is loading, and in the home page we are adding this object here. We add
our name to show the page. Yes. Exactly, correct.
Okay.
Okay. So any other questions? Okay, so you can continue on Monday with this particular the pending concept validation and other concepts also will continue on Monday.
No more doubts, Suresh.
Yes.
This binding result means if we are getting any errors in this model attribute this action, that results will be binded to that binding result. The errors will be binded here.
Yes, whatever the errors we are, the pattern related information we are going to get in the particular result object.
But what type of errors will be binded?
Yes, that is nothing but model attribute is nothing but that is a concept. In the register class, we already specified this form errors, right?
Okay.
So the, on top of this particular username, if missed anything, this particular form.errors is going to identify. And this is going to return as a the model attribute register. In the model attribute register, we are getting this register, and this is easily recognized any errors are having. So that we are going to get as a result object.
Okay. Thanks.
Okay, we can continue on Monday.